Good morning, everyone. So my days in the past few weeks have been monotonous. There's nothing fancy, there's nothing pretty good, just working. And for my spare time, I usually will practice a bit guitar and write some stuff. Yeah, it's been pretty boring days. So today I'm gonna do something pretty special, and I try to be very whimsical about it, but I'm not sure if I can do it right because I'm a very serious guy. And looking back those videos that I've done, for example, for the Hong Kong accent English, and it looks pretty fun. I think those days I was pretty dumb to do all these videos, but anyway, let's do it again. So today I'm gonna show to you how to learn Hong Kong English the expensive way or the unexpected way. So in order for me to show to you how to speak Hong Kong English, definitely I'm going to speak Hong Kong English throughout this video. So the first method is to book a flight from your place to Hong Kong to live for some time. I know during this pandemic it's very hard for you to do this, but please put this into your own mind, and in the future you can use it. So if you happen to know a little bit of Cantonese, when you come here, don't speak Cantonese. You have to pretend yourself like an ABC or BBC or banana. There's a wise man say that if you hang around the barbershop long enough, sooner or later you'll get a haircut. So if you hang around Hong Kong downtown long enough, you'll get beaten up. Oh, I mean spoken up. And the best way to learn is to be. So be in Hong Kong, live the culture in Hong Kong. So the second method is also very expensive. I think it's the most expensive method, is to study in Hong Kong. So I don't care whether you get a master degree or bachelor degree, as long as you're studying in Hong Kong for at least 1 year, I guarantee you can master the quintessence of Hong Kong English. I'm no kidding here. This is the real example. So when you study in Hong Kong, definitely you'll know a lot of Hong Kong classmates, a lot of local people. You might even get a girlfriend, I don't know. And another thing which is very good is that every single day you can able to listen to lecturers speaking Hong Kong English for at least 2 or 3 hours a day. So subconsciously you're able to assimilate yourself into this local culture on how to speak Hong Kong English. So I still remember there's one lecturer, he's a local Hong Konger, and whenever he speaks with a very authentic and modern Hong Kong English. For example, he say, as you look at the graph, the trend exponentially increases, and with approximately a few millimeter increase in diameter, so the momentum will get bigger, stronger, faster, and better. So what can you listen from this phrase? A lot of R sound, and there's no R sound. So Hong Kong people cannot pronounce the R sound. They cannot literally say the R word. They only say R-lo. For example, GT-R-lo.
我要买GT-R-lo.
我买Benz给你啊.
我要买GT-R-lo.
So from here, I can notice that Hong Kong people could never ever pronounce the R sound. For example, product, property, probably, promise, producer, proportion, protest, procrastinate, and professional. I think we need to prepare this presentation slide properly because the professor was putting a lot of pressure on us. I don't want to get very bad grade. I think this year I may not get a promotion because the last few projects were pretty bad, and I might not even get a salary raise. So there is no R sound. And of course, there are lots of R sound. I don't know why Hong Kong people like to say R at the front. I can give you some example. Assume, approve, alert, alarm, along, approximate, alone, allow, apologize, apply, appreciate, appearance, appointment, and also R sound at the back. Like I mentioned, the professor say better, faster, stronger, weaker. You have to remember, this food is cheaper, he is a doctor, they are a lot of construction worker. A lot of R sound, and there is no R-lo sound. So from these two little and very obvious tricks, you can learn how to speak Hong Kong English precisely. So after you have finished your education, master or bachelor, so at the end of the day, there's two things that you'll get. First is your certification. Second is know how to speak Hong Kong English. So with the certification, I can get an interview. With Hong Kong English, I can nail the interview. So at the end of the day, I can get a job. So let me summarize all the tips. The first one is to get a flight ticket and live in Hong Kong for several months. I don't care. Don't leave for a few days. It's not going to work. Try to leave for several months and speak only English. The second tip is to get an education in Hong Kong, not only to learn all these skill sets or whatever it is, or even to get a certification. Other than that, you need to learn how to speak Hong Kong English so you can get a life in Hong Kong. So that's all my tips on how to learn Hong Kong English, the most expensive and unexpected way. So you probably need to spend maybe 200,000 Hong Kong dollars to do it. Worth it or not, I'm not sure. I will leave it to you guys to decide. So that's all from me. I will see you in the next video.